Crippled by the loss of their supply route, the twin cities of Shangyang and Fengcheng were ready to fall. The Mongols' new long-range trebuchets would test the mighty walls of the Song Fortress, and Kublai Khan would not stop the bombardment until he sat on the throne of all China. After years of resisting Kublai Khan's siege, Fengcheng and Shangyang still refused to submit to Mongol rule. To take the cities, Kublai Khan would harness the full power of his empire by enlisting an ally from the Ilkhanate of Persia. Ismail, a siege expert, would lead the Mongol army in the construction of the Huihui Pao, an immensely powerful counterweight trebuchet. This new trebuchet, once constructed, could hurl boulders greater in size than any weapon before it. During the years-long siege, Kublai Khan had established lucrative trade routes with Chinese market towns who swore loyalty to him. Although these trade partners were vulnerable to Song attacks, they could deliver valuable resources to fund Ismail's efforts. The Mongol commercial network could supply Ismail in stone so long as he had enough traders on the road.
Thank you. 我们那命令要来留。
现在听我指令，出发。
나도라 아직도 그는 보이자.
오시아드 그저 봐야만.
Ашлах цаг боллоо.
Цагтай дээр ширээ дээр тийгөө.
Би танд байхгүй шүү. Намайг хааш явуулахгүй бай. Зүйтэй. Хинд ажил хийхгүй.
Энд шиг төрөг агнасуу.
Эрэгтэй тушаад ирж байв. Тушаадаар хишүү түмүү.
Та юун хэмээн тушаад бой. Би юун хийх бой.
Аму сэтүүгээ
түүх. Хайцтай хэлтээр тушаад.
Явц цаг боллоо. Миний чад билэг.
Юу хийж эхлэх нь намайг хаш явуулхгүй бай.
Миний чад
чи юу хүсвэл?
Би юу хийх вэ? Явган зэрэг билэг.
Шаг бол цаг бол бай.
Schutte! Mit!
Зүйтэй, хэнд ажил хэрэгтвэй?
Би, юу хийж хэлэсэх бой? Ажил хуя мэлэн! Эрчүүдээс, шэн тушаал ирлээ, бэдэм ба! Үүрхтээ, үйтхүүр! Тайд хүчөөх, тайд хүчин зүтэгсөө! Удалгүй бидний тушаал ирвэ. Ажиллах цаг боллоо.
Сэгүүсэд замыг мүйн үүн хэрэг. Үйн үйлтхүй нүү миний зам үйн үйн.
Coming, he's going to help. 매듭 버섯몰 얼트리굿에 얼트골 얼트리굿 엔젤굿
허둔득 차기 안발등이 없소
요해제스트보이 목천스 비 기슈 도무이
무시화계 일당 버스
주제 어떠세요?
어떻게 걸어 베이징?
나도 알지도 그노.
도시아지 딱 보야 베이징.
어디 갔다 왔니?
With the counterweight trebuchet constructed, the Mongols could mount their assault on the twin cities. As Ismail's trebuchet had a far greater range than those of the Song defenders, the Mongols could attack from a safe distance.
Акан душе. Акан душе.
ажиллах цаг бол тушаал буулгах цаг бол бай.
Дуусахгүй.
Өөрийгөө түгүү барай дуусахгүй.
Тушаад болгох цаг болгүй.
Юу вэ? Энд ажил хэрэгтэй.
Цугаар анхааралтай байна уу?
Тушаа сонсогдохгүй. Цуст тулаана бэлэн.
Bombardment from the trebuchet. The Song soldiers left gaps elsewhere in their defense, which the Mongols could exploit.
тэднийг таахгүй. Эндүүд өгөхгүй. Тэд таргуй байхгүй.
Миний чад бидэг. Миний тушаатыг хүлээгүү.
Миний чад бидэг.
Дайсник бүрдэлдэг. Тэднийг тараасу.
Харуулхой бидэн байна.
Энийг харахгүй бүү.
И юу ч хийх
боломжгүй юм. Харахгүй.
Оогадаа ажилла бид нөө.
Эхди хайрууд байгуул.
Ja, was da?
Wenn du nur noch zu tun, kein Harmus bei mir!
So scharf, wo der Bionik hat auf dem Hizu.
Musst du dich hier auf Beijing? Doch, doch!
Bridge rebuilt, the doors to Fancheng were wide open. The Mongols swept into Fancheng, striking down any Song warriors in their path.
Доша нэг нагсу. Хэй бой. Заврыг дагах твой. Жа. Доша нэг нагсу.
After years of holding out against the Mongols, the first of the Twin Cities finally fell to Kublai Khan's army. All that now stood between Kublai Khan and the throne of China was the final stronghold of the Song, the city of Shangyang. Using the immense range of the great trebuchet, Ismail aimed to lay waste to Shangyang's great keep.
Ich schau, wie ich der Bock war. Чи юу хүсэм үү?
Ажиллах цаг боллоо. Хөдөлгөө яа бидэн. Ажиллахуу яа бидэн. Зүйтэй, энд ажил хэрэгтэй. Одоо үүнийг барьсуу. Би түүнийг удлгүй бариад дуусгасуу. Зүйтэй.
Цугаар анхааралтай байна уу?
Би гишүү төмөй гүйцэтгэсүү.
Агс, шинэ тушаал ирлээ.
Бодолдаар хэрэглэн явм уу?
Эрчүүдээ, бэлж!
Бичээсүү.
Эрчүүдэ, бэл. Эрчүүдэ, хөдөл.
Бүгд сонс. Зугаар анхааралтай байна уу?
Тэгээ.
Одоо үүнийг барьсуу.
Чи юу хүс мөн?
Эцлэх бой.
Тушаад болгох цаг болгүй. За, би үнийг шалхуун хийсүү.
Та юун тушаахыг хүсэх вэ?
Сост тул
тушаадар болсон.
Шаа түдэ хүйт байдин. Мэни үгээр яуғын хуэр.
Надуғын ажил үгін.
Эрчүүдэ бэд.
Тушаад болғых цаг бол бай. Таны тушаадыг бүгд үгүй дагмүй. Таны хүслийг ёсчлон биелүүлсүү. Хөдөл туулах зам бүрт. Таануус бүгд хөдөл.
Эрчүүдээ зоригтой
тугаар анхааралтай байна уу? Таны тушаадаар болсуу.
Ismail's counterweight trebuchet proved its might, shaking the earth and shattering the spirits of the song. The great keep of Shangyang had fallen. With Shangyang's gate undefended, the Mongols could now repair the connecting bridge to the Song stronghold. With the city in disarray, the Mongols were free to tear down the imperial palace. Mongol warriors flooded the streets of Shangyang as the Song defenders rose to make a desperate last stand. Shangyang, the great bastion of the Song dynasty, had fallen. Kublai Khan had finished what his grandfather, Genghis Khan, had started. And now, he could establish his own great dynasty and sit on the throne of all China. The Mongol army smashed through Shangyang's defenses and captured the city. Kublai Khan then pursued the remnants of the Song dynasty across southern China. In 1279, at the Battle of Yamen, the Mongols destroyed the last defenders of the Song. Kublai Khan now ruled over all China, founding the Yuan dynasty. His royal court in Chengdu welcomed scholars, traders, and religious leaders. The Mongols demonstrated civility and religious tolerance, but also brutality and violence, typifying the contradictions within the Mongol Empire. Since Genghis Khan first united the Mongolian tribes, they had made incredible advances in technology and trade. And they created indelible connections between East and West. At its height, almost 100 million people lived under Mongol rule, a quarter of the world's population. The Mongol Empire endured for less than 200 years before fragmenting into smaller territories, but its legend continues to this day. Genghis Khan's mission was to unite the world into one empire. Yet he always returned to the Mongolian steppe, where the endless grasslands lay beneath the eternal sky, and from where he created one of the largest empires the world has ever known.